These are various cargo motors. This is a windshield wiper motor. It cleans car windows. This other one is a car window lifter motor. I mounted this aluminum pulley for a previous job. This is a motor from a car rearview mirror. I use it when I need less power. This is a cheap commercial DC motor and costs about $16. This commercial also costs about $10. They are all geared motors and therefore powerful, and they can all become powerful servos. Let's take this and turn it into a very powerful servo. I'll show you how. This is a 5 kiloohm potentiometer to be fixed to the crankshaft. As you can see from the oscilloscope, the servo pulses range from a minimum of 0.5 milliseconds to a maximum of 2.5 milliseconds. And this is the train of pulses that are 20 milliseconds apart. Let's take a servo with broken mechanics and recover the good electronics. Let's remove the potentiometer. Let's also remove the motor. These are the three connections of the potentiometer. And these are the two motor connections. And this is the diagram. We will use this drive for motors that draw up to 2 amperes. Instead, for motors that absorb more than 2 amperes, we will use this drive which supports up to 43 amperes. And now let's go and build our cards. I don't make printed circuit boards for the simple reason that I only build prototypes, and in this way I can modify the cards as I want. And here are the two cards assembled. The motor absorbs to 0.2 amperes, but when starting it absorbs to 0.6 amperes. So we can't use the 2 ampere drive. we will use the 43 ampere drive. This is the servo electronics we recovered. This is the potentiometer connected to the servo electronics. Here we have the motor fused. The 12 volt switch. Here I mounted to photocouplers. These are important. If the drive breaks, the 12 volts burn the servo electronics up to the Arduino, which is inside the servo test. So it's a protection. This is a test servo that I built myself and allows you to move for servos simultaneously. Each potentiometer corresponds to a color. Yellow corresponds to the yellow output, blue corresponds to the blue output, green and brown. The connections 12 volt for the motor, the ground, 5 volt for the logic. Potentiometer positive, potentiometer center, potentiometer negative. This is the signal coming from the servo tester. Then we have the black and red wire of the motor, which can be reversed depending on the behavior of the motor with respect to the potentiometer. When the two LEDs are on at the same time, it means that the motor is stopped and the two potentiometers are aligned. Making the motor move, we see that one LED indicates one direction of the motor, and the other LED indicates the opposite direction. In order to find the right position of the arm when it is connected to the robot, by rotating the back of the potentiometer, you can find the exact position. Obviously, it must be blocked afterwards. DC motors in cars cost very little. They are geared motors and are very powerful. My body shop gives them to me. With 16 of these motors, I built a robot.